Hi, this is Graham from Genems Astro. In this video, I will be reviewing the Celestron NexYZ 3-axis universal smartphone adapter. This adapter allows you to position and hold a smartphone over the eyepiece of a telescope, a spotting scope, or a microscope, so you can take photos without the need for more sophisticated equipment like a digital SLR. In the UK, it costs around £50 and about $60 in the US. And one of the most popular videos on my channel has been of another smartphone adapter, which retails for about a third of the price of this one. So in this video, we'll see if the Celestron product is worth the higher price. So what's in the box? Well, you get the adapter itself. Here it is. You get a sheet of multilingual instructions, which have some useful pictures to help you to set up the adapter. And then finally, you get a couple of cuffs, which really are plastic rings that you can put around small eyepieces, maybe with a microscope, and they allow you just to pad out any distance between that eyepiece and the mechanism that clamps the adapter. It's packaged inside a nice colourful box. It's lined in foam. And that's all really quite nice packaging. The adapter itself, well, it weighs 285 grams. So this compares with 165 for the other adapter that I reviewed. So the NexYZ is heavier, but really it's not excessively heavy. The construction is mainly of plastic, although there are some small metal bolts and screws. And I'd say it feels solid enough to do the job. Adapters like this, they're always going to look a little bit unwieldy, a little bit like spiders, because you're trying to connect different pieces of equipment together. But you get used to it after a while. Another little touch, the adapter has got the classic Celestron orange and black colouring, and I think it looks quite smart to the eye. Okay, so how do you attach the adapter to an eyepiece in a scope? Well, you've got a couple of options. You can either attach the put the eyepiece into the scope first and then put the adapter onto it, or you can put the adapter onto the eyepiece first and then place them both into the telescope. So that's your choice. I think generally I've put the eyepiece into the telescope first, but it's just a personal preference to see what works for you. But basically, the attachment of the adapter to an eyepiece is a two-stage process. So firstly, you have a clamp here, which as you can see is a spring-loaded mechanism. So it fits around eyepieces with outside diameters in the range of 30 to 60 millimeters. So that should be fine for most normal 1.25 and indeed most 2-inch eyepieces. So as I mentioned, the adapter is supplied with a couple of these, which are expanding plastic cuffs, and those could be used to fit across a smaller diameter eyepiece if you have one. I haven't used those. So after what you basically do then, after you've opened up the jaws of the clamp, you put those around the eyepiece like this, and then you can see, I hope, that there is a mechanism here to screw down the clamp onto the eyepiece. Maybe if I look this way around, it's a little bit easier to see. So that allows you to attach the two together quite firmly. And then if you want to reverse the process, well, you undo the locking screw here, rotate the nut from that, and then you open the clamp and remove the eyepiece. And then you're free to obviously change to another eyepiece, whatever you want to do. So the process continues. I say it's slightly more fiddly than the other adapter I've used, but you get used to it. So moving on to attaching the phone, again, you can do all of this in the order that suits you. So basically, the adapter is fitted with a sliding clamp. So it is spring-loaded, hopefully you can see that. And it's designed to fit a range of phone and phablet sizes. And if we put the camera into the adapter, I'd say it holds it on the three sides, and the question is, how well does it grip? Well, I mean, you're probably holding a phone here that could cost £500 or more quite easily. You don't want to test the insurance cover by dropping it. So I'd say shaking the adapter with the camera installed, well, there you go. It's a pretty subjective test, but I say it holds it on pretty securely, but obviously I offer no guarantees. So how do you adjust the adapter to get the image that you want? Well, the main feature of the adapter is hinted at by the name. Not only does NexYZ fit with the existing Celestron product line in terms of being similar in name to the NexStar products, but the XYZ refers to the ability to adjust the positioning of the camera with respect to the eyepiece in three axes. So you've got the X, the Y, and the Z axes. If you've used an adapter that only really allows an adjustment in the X and the Y axis, that is to say left and right and up and down, you'll know that whilst you can centralize the image in the field of the smartphone camera, you can't adjust it easily to get the right size of image. And the problem is you want to either increase or decrease the separation between the camera lens and the eyepiece lens. And if you haven't got a built-in adjustment for that, it is tempting to try and move the phone so that it's perhaps isn't so securely held by the clamping on that particular adapter. And that's where trouble can start, and ultimately you can have a situation where the phone falls out of the adapter, which obviously isn't good. So with the NexYZ, full adjustment is promised. So if we have a closer look at the adjustment mechanism, I'll turn the adapter over, and hopefully you can see that there are three adjustment knobs. There's one here, there's one here, and there's a smaller one here. Now, adjusting each one in turn, this knob here is moving the phone in X, so it's moving it left to right. This one here is moving it up and down, so you see it's going up in the Y axis. And then this smaller one here is moving, so looking from the side, is moving the camera in and out in the Z axis relative to the position that the eyepiece will be. Remember that the eyepiece is normally clamped inside in the jaws like this. So each adjustment has got an adjustment knob that is a different shape, which is a nice feature really if you're going to use the adapter at night, because you can, in theory, perhaps not that easy between the X and the Y, but you can tell which of the adjustments that you're holding by the shape. So that's quite nice. The mechanisms, I say that they're lightweight, but they're very tidily installed, and they seem to be certainly good enough for the purpose. So I'd say, yeah, the mechanism is quite clever. Some nice features. Okay, so let's try and see this working. So initially I've got the telescope looking out into my garden at a bird table, and I've set up the eyepiece and telescope focused on the target so that it's in the centre of the field. And then we're going to put the phone onto the adapter, and then we're going to clamp it on to the eyepiece. Like so, nice and tight. Now at the moment can't see any image, so I'm just going to play around with the adjustment knob. So in the x-axis, so you can see that it scans the image across. There we go, they can start to see the image there. You can adjust it up and down with the Y, and then finally see with the Z. It's bringing it closer to the eyepiece, that's touching there, just to show you the full range of travel. And then we go right the way out, that is as far out as we can go. You can note some purple reflection here, the light off the coating on the eyepiece, and then probably that's about the sweet spot there. So that'd be ideal for a still photo, like so, or if you go to video, then the field of view is different, so all automatically we've lost some of that tunneling effect, and we're filling most of the field of view. So yeah, it's relatively simple to use. It takes a little bit of practice, but the adjustment in X, Y, and Z is pretty easy to use.
Now, before I give my opinion, please can I ask that you subscribe to the Jenham's Astro channel in order that you get notifications of other Astro videos that might be of interest to you. So go on, please press that red subscribe button. Okay, so now, is the Celestron NexYZ good or bad? Well, I'd say it's mostly good. The things that I like, the three-axis adjustment is well thought out and it's quite intuitive to use. The camera is held very securely and it's held on three sides, so that's a strong point compared to some other smartphone adapters on the market. And whilst initially the combination of the clamp and the screw mechanism might seem a little bit awkward, in practice it works quite well. Okay, so that's all good. I have two quibbles, probably quite small. As I said, the clamping generally works very well, but it can slip around eyepieces if they're not contoured or rubberized. So for example, I use some old Halloween eyepieces. They're my favorites and they're fantastic. They are smooth along the sides and they are glorious in every way. But this adapter can slip unless you've tightened it up. So there's a solution to that. Just make sure it is tight, and that's in general good in order that the whole process works better when you're using a smartphone with your telescope. Secondly, the cost maybe is a little bit high. If you shop around, you can save a few pennies, and maybe I recommend that you do that. Now, my other observations are generic, really. They apply to many adapters. After all, what we're trying to do here is we're trying to mate a camera that's on the corner of a rectangular phone with a circular cone of light, and we're trying to do that with a piece of kit that isn't heavy, that isn't hugely expensive like a lot of Astro kit. This isn't an easy task to achieve. I think Celestron have done it very well, but I think you must remember that using adapters like this is always going to have a somewhat fiddly aspect to it. Nothing's clamped on tight like you've got with a digital SLR, but as long as you accept that you've got to take a little bit of care setting everything up, tightening things down, maybe not sort of nudging the arrangement too much when you're trying to take a nice photo, then that goes with the territory, really. So for still images, often you'll have to use the zoom feature in order to fill the frame of the camera. Or alternatively, you can crop the final image that you have. If you shoot video, generally that improves that because it has a smaller field of view. Okay, then reflections. If you're using the camera during daylight or if you're using it for astro targets where maybe you've got a neighbour's light nearby, you can get reflections off the coating of the eyepiece and they can appear in the photo that you're trying to take. Now, this can be quite a problem during daytime. Now, depending on the eyepiece you're using, you can possibly shade some of that light if it has a rubber cap, or maybe you can hold your hand over where the source of light to stop it from reflecting off the eyepiece. But you've got to be aware of that, really, that because there is naturally a separation of the camera from the telescope, that there is an opportunity for some light to get in and influence your picture. But really, those are all generic points. They can really apply to any adapter, but you should be aware of them when you're looking to use a smartphone with a telescope. So would I recommend the Celestron NexYZ? Yes, I would. For me, it is worth the price. The Z-axis adjustment, really, that's the clincher. It removes the temptations that can cause an expensive phone to slip from a lesser adapter. Add to this the impression that Celestron have paid quite a lot of attention to detail. For example, in the distinction of the different adjustment knobs and in the way that the camera is held onto the adapter. Some nice design features. So for me, it's definitely worth giving it a try. I hope this review has been useful. Once again, please subscribe to my channel, and thanks very much for watching.